Hey guys, welcome back to TerraFirmaCraft. Now in today's episode, we're going to be making the blast furnace and hopefully making some steel as well. But before we do that, I want to give you a quick tour of the house, show you what I've done since the last episode, and also talk to you a bit about crashes. So recently I've had a couple of comments about crashes. Someone said that their TerraFirmaCraft crashes all the time. And one of the main problems you might be having is a lack of RAM allocated to Minecraft. I've actually been having a lot of crashes recently as well. Before I show you around the house quickly, olive trees, these are ready. And this is what olive trees look like when they're ripe. It's quite hard to tell that they're ripe actually, but that's what they look like. Cool, we've got some olives now as well. So yeah, I've recently been having a lot of crashes. Pretty much every time I try and load into my world first time, I would crash like instantly. And I think that was because I didn't have enough RAM allocated to Minecraft or TerraFirmaCraft, basically the Forge profile that I'm using. So I've heard that TerraFirmaCraft basically needs, or it's recommended that you have at least 1 gig of RAM allocated to Minecraft or the profile that you're using to run TerraFirmaCraft. And obviously the standard is just 1 gig of RAM max, and it's recommended that you have 1 gig minimum. So yeah, I only had 1 gig max RAM, and I was trying to run this with just 1 gig, and I think that was the main problem for why I kept crashing. And also, chiseled blocks or detailed blocks can also cause crashes, like when you're trying to load into your world. If you have a lot of detailed blocks or chiseled blocks around where you're trying to spawn in, that can also cause you to crash. So I've got rid of most of the slabby bits around the path. It doesn't look quite as good, but at least I can actually play in the world now as well. And I've also, if I hit my F3 button here, you'll see that I've got in the top right corner, it says used memory 20% of 3000 megabytes, so I should have 3 gig allocated to Minecraft now, or TerraFirmaCraft at least anyway. But underneath that it says allocated memory 775 megabytes. I'm not too sure if that's the actual RAM that I've allocated, or if that's just the minimum, or I'm not too sure what that number's about. I thought that was going to match the used memory number, so I thought they'd both be like 3 gig or 4 gig or whatever you put in there. But that did actually start out as 500, then it's gone up to 600 megabytes, now it's at 700 megabytes. And I haven't really had a problem since allocating more RAM and getting rid of some of the chiseled stuff. So if you're having a lot of problems crashing when trying to load into your world, I recommend doing that. I'm not going to show you how to allocate more RAM to Minecraft in this video. There's loads and loads of tutorials online. You should go check them out if you're having troubles with that. And also if you know anything about why those numbers don't match, if that's going to be a problem or anything, if I've done anything wrong because I'm stupid and newbie, then let me know. But yeah, let's take a look around the house. Hopefully that should fix any issues that you've been having. As I said, I haven't actually crashed since allocating more RAM, which is good. So I haven't really done much to the outside around here except extend the roof. And I've also changed up the textures of the roof. I said in the last episode I didn't like the amount of hickory that was going on. And you'll notice here, this is actually maple logs. It's quite a similar texture, quite a similar colour to the hickory, but slightly different. It's a little bit more stripey. And basically I've just kind of the edge blocks are all hickory, and then kind of the middle of the roof, the top of the roof, is this maple stuff. So just to give it a different texture, and also to break up the textures, because if they're all just the same thing going the same way, it looks a bit strange as well. I've also placed some logs vertically just to break up the texture here and there. If we move along down the roof, I've kind of extended the building out to add another room. I think I'm going to leave this room kind of like this with the roof and a really high ceiling. Got a nice little painting there. Also thinking of having a little extension slash doorway area here as well, so that we don't have to walk all the way around to get in. And it's looking pretty cool. I've also added the roof part to this edge. It's actually a block wider each side than the front of the roof or front of the house. But I think it looks okay. It doesn't look too different, too strange. And if we take a step back and take a look at the different textures, like the maple logs and the hickory, you can't really see it too well because the sun is over that side. If we go around the other side, but it just breaks it up, basically. You can see it quite well from here. A slightly different texture on the top of the roof. It's not too noticeable. It's not too different. And I really like it, actually. The vertical logs definitely help to break up the textures as well. So yeah, good stuff. I've also, if you follow me on Twitter, you may have seen a tweet that I've actually worked out how to breed wolves. And oh yes, I have. You'll see if we right-click Blaze here, she's pregnant, which is amazing. So I'll show you guys how to do that at the end of the episode. Hopefully we can get her to actually have the babies and then breed them again. Because, yeah, that would be nice to actually show you how to breed them and get it working. But basically, the basic idea of it is I was trying to breed them with raw meat while they were just normally, just like vanilla. But in TerraFirmaCraft, you actually have to feed these guys cooked meat so that they're not hungry anymore, and then you can breed them with raw meat. So if you click this guy... Don't! Jimmy, you stupid Jimmy! I knew he was the stupid one. Okay, so if we click Rick with the cooked meat, you'll hear the eating sound until he stands up and we can't feed him with the cooked meat anymore. Oh, you're back, Jimmy. Do you want some food? And we do the same with Jimmy, and now they're not hungry anymore, and now they're ready to breed. So that was the problem. I was basically just feeding them raw meat, and I wasn't getting them to breed. Although the love hearts were showing, they weren't actually in breed mode. So let's give you some food as well, as you're pregnant. You're eating for multiple. So wolves will actually have three or four puppies when they give birth as well. So pretty cool. We should have a few more wolves and try and get her to breed at the end of the episode. But that's basically how you do it. You got to feed them. And you might have to play around with sitting and standing, different combinations of the male and female sitting and standing. So I had them both standing. They wouldn't breed. I had to basically sit the male dog down and then the female one was still standing and then they could breed. Pretty strange, but you know, that's mods for you, that's Minecraft mods. So it does work. You kind of have to fiddle around with it, but it does work. Anyway, let's get down to the main business of today's episode. Actually, no, not just yet. I want to do something else quickly, sorry. If you're tuning in just for the blast furnace, the steel stuff, we will get down to that in a second. Hold your horses. Haha, no pun intended. We horses, get it? Don't know. Anyway, someone requested or suggested that I name the male horse the Stallion Galaxy. Unfortunately, I'd already named him. But we do have a male baby or foal, and he actually looks exactly like his mother and his father. So I guess we could call this little guy Galaxy. I don't see the harm in that. So here you go. We have a little Galaxy. Seems like he likes the name. I like it. Hope you guys like it. Anyway, let's get down to making some steel and the blast furnace. Hopefully everything's running smoothly, although I'm getting quite low frame rates at the second. That's been happening quite a lot recently. My frame rates seem to be suffering. I'm not too sure what's doing it. But yeah, also on the subject of chiseled blocks and stuff, I may have to change the amount of pillars that I've got on that symmetry, because that may also be causing me to lag and crash and all sorts of stuff. But anyway, steel and mainly the blast furnace. So I've been working on making loads and loads of iron sheets and double sheets. So for the blast furnace, you're going to need 8 wrought iron double sheets, 12 wrought iron normal sheets, and also a two-year, any, I don't think it has to be iron, the two-year, just any type of two-year, which is basically made using a double sheet, and you pound it out using the anvil, just select the recipe and make yourself a two-year. And what you do now, I think, is surround, I'm going to need that other crucible, aren't I? I think we surround a crucible with 8 iron double sheets. Let me take that. So let's try that. I'm pretty sure that's how we do it. So 8 double sheets around the crucible, and that will give us a blast furnace. And this is what we need to make steel. And similar to all the other forgery type of things, this is going to be a multi-block structure. So like the forge needs a chimney and so on, and so does the bloomery. This is going to need a few blocks around it. So the first one you need to do is a crucible just on the floor. Basically, this is going to be your base block, and wherever you place this, you'll be placing the blast furnace around it. I wish I'd actually planned for this and made a nice space for it, but unfortunately I didn't. I may have to actually move it into the big house once we've got it working, but for now I'm just going to sit it in the middle of the room here. So crucible on the bottom, blast furnace goes on top of that, right? Hey, what? Okay, maybe we have to actually have a forge below the crucible for it to work. That might be the case. I'm going to take a quick break and I'll see if we need a forge or something, and I'll get it all set up. So I will be right back. Okay, so I don't think it's anything to do with having a forge down here. I've put a forge there. For that forge to work, I basically had to knock this block out of the ceiling so that it counts as a chimney. I put the crucible on top of that, and the blast furnace still doesn't go on top of there. So I think what we need to do is actually place the rest of the structure before we place the blast furnace down. Okay, so we're going to need 4 fire brick blocks. I showed you how to make these in the last episode. If you don't know how to make them, you're going to need fire clay, which uses graphite, kaolinite powder, and clay. And you basically just do that, and that will give you 2 bricks. You need 10 of those and some mortar. Oh no, I didn't mean to do that. You need 10 of those and some mortar to get these fire brick blocks. And for every level of the blast furnace, or for every tier, you'll need 4 fire brick blocks and 12 iron sheets. And each level will allow you to process 4 units or 4 pieces of ore more, basically. If that makes any sense. So each level will basically allow you to process 4 pieces of ore, and the more you put, the more you can process. So that's the fire brick blocks. Let's get rid of these planks because we don't need those. That's just to get the structure there. This block needs to be air, and we need to take the iron sheets and place them on the sides of these fire bricks. They don't need to be on the top or bottom, just on the sides. So right click on the sides with the sheets in your hands and just cover them like so. You can do this with other metals, so it's basically wrought iron or any higher tier metal. I'm not too sure why you'd want to use a higher tier metal, that's kind of silly. So that is the basic structure. Now all we need to do is put the blast furnace down, and yeah, it actually lets us put it down now. We also need to put the tuyere in this slot here, and also put some bellows. Aha, are we going to need a block there? I think we are. Put some bellows next to the blast furnace. Is that pumping the right? That's pumping the wrong way. I need an axe or a saw, and let's put it this side, in fact, and that's pumping the right way. Cool. So that is our blast furnace setup. Now, to actually use this, we need to be able to climb to the top and place ores inside. So this is going to be really messy and really ugly, but it has to be done. So now we basically have to use some iron ore. I've got some hematite in here somewhere. I went and collected some more. And some flux and some charcoal. Let's get some charcoal. I've got loads of that. And flux is basically made. You can use marble, or there are some other types of stone that you can get flux from. And where's my hammer? You basically use the stones and a hammer, and that'll give you flux. So to make steel, or to make pig iron, which will eventually turn into steel, you need to throw iron ore and equal amounts of flux and charcoal, if not more charcoal. So as I said, the max each level can handle is 4 pieces of ore, so I can only use 4 pieces of ore at a time until I upgrade this thing. It also says on the wiki that you have to throw these things in all at the same time. Now, I'm not sure, but that seems impossible to me. I can't throw everything in at once, so I'm going to put 8 pieces of charcoal, because it's equal amounts of charcoal or more, equal amounts of flux, and hopefully this works. Let's throw them in, flux and charcoal, and the extra charcoal is just sitting on the top there. Nice. Now, I think as we melt stuff up in this, the charcoal is actually going to be used up, so we have to keep supplying it with charcoal, so you have to keep an eye on it. Let me just eat something so I don't starve to death. And all that's left to do now, I think, is to just right-click on the blast furnace. So we see here that it's got equal amounts of charcoal to ore, so as this starts smelting, we're going to need to keep adding more charcoal. Let's use the flint and steel, and this guy is cooking. We can see that it's now lit up, and if we check the top, that should be lit up as well. Cool, just like the bloomery. Now, as you can see, it's used up some of the charcoal, so as this thing works, it's going to use the charcoal and process the ore. As it processes the ore, that's going to flow into this crucible down here, and I should probably get some ingot cast in there to catch anything that wants to go in there. Or some ceramic molds, I guess they're called. Right, there we go. I think we actually do need the bellows to get this to a higher temperature for it to actually smelt the ore. So it's not, if you just leave it, it's not going to do anything. You actually need to use the bellows to get it to a higher temperature for it to smelt the ore into pig iron. Aha, it seems some of it has flowed into the crucible and is being poured into that ingot cast. Let's check it out here. Ore has gone down a little bit. We need to add some more charcoal. Ooh, and it's even gone down noticeably there. Let's also chuck another piece of ore in there. No, that's not going to allow it to take it. Apparently there's no ore left in there now. We've got a full pig iron ingot. That is amazing. Our first ever. And let's see if we can throw some more ore in the top here. You're going to take it? Oh, you probably need flux as well, don't you? So let's put flux and ore together. Aha, now it takes it when it's flux and ore together. Let's also do one more, because 4 is the max. And how are you doing for charcoal? Not bad. Okay, so now, I'm just going to leave this for a second. Hopefully it won't do anything silly while I just show you how to actually turn this pig iron into steel. So put the you let it cool down to a solid temperature. As you can see, can weld, can work. It's still really hot, so while it's hot, we put it in here, and if you look in the plans, we can turn this into a high carbon steel ingot. We just need to do 3 hits. Now it's a high carbon steel ingot. We also need to do it again to turn it into a steel ingot. So let's do that and just hammer it three times once again. And also match it up with the lines. Aha, and now we have a steel ingot. Amazing. Now this is steel. First ever. Let's throw it up in celebration. That didn't quite work as it was supposed to. So now we've got steel. We basically use this to make other types of steel. So this is kind of like your base, and then you add things to it to make different types, like red steel, blue steel, black steel. Cool. I think to actually make the other stuff, we're going to need a steel anvil, which sounds like it's going to be a lot of work. This is certainly a lot of work to keep this going. You basically have to keep pressing these bellows to actually get the stuff to turn into liquid, I think, and then it will flow into there. I need to also put a mold in there. And it seems like the crucible is keeping the temperature of whatever metal is in there, or the blast furnace. It may actually be feeding off the blast furnace's temperature, I'm not too sure. But the main thing is, it's working. I have a steel ingot, and I'm so happy about that. Let's cool it down and see what it looks like placed. So, shift-right-click on there. And nothing too special, but it took a long time to actually get to this stage, so it is kind of special, even though it doesn't look it. So, this is how you make steel. It seems like a really complex process. This tuyere is going to take damage each time you make stuff. And I am going to have to make a lot of this and actually work out how we make red steel and all the different types of steel. I may leave this until, like, I'll do the rest of this off camera, I think, because it seems like it's going to take a long time and I need to get this episode recorded if I want to get it uploaded today. So, anyway, I'm going to empty this out. I'm going to do a quick sleep and then we'll take a look around the house and hopefully breed those wolves. So, once again, I will be right back. Okay, guys, so it's been a couple of in-game days since I was making the steel. We only managed to get like two ingots cooked up. I'll have to see how many we need for the anvil and some other stuff like that, because obviously we won't be able to make any steel tools or steel armor until we have an anvil, a steel anvil. So, I was hoping that the female dog will have given birth by now, but unfortunately she hasn't. We don't have any puppies. I think it takes a few in-game months, and I think it's probably only been about 1 month in-game, so I may have to wait till the next episode, possibly even the one after that. It shouldn't be too long before we get some puppies and we can breed them again. But I showed you guys how to breed them, or I told you how to breed them if you missed that. Basically, you need to feed them with cooked meat before you can breed them with raw meat. And once they stop eating the cooked meat, they should be good to breed. And you may have to mess about with standing and sitting positions, different with the male and female. Cool. That should be done in the next episode. Hopefully we get some nice little puppies that we can name. And I'll also build an area for them somewhere. Maybe an outside doghouse over here somewhere. I'm thinking of doing a kind of patio area out here that kind of just goes out into the forest, maybe. Maybe just even a door, and I put the patio here, or some kind of flower garden, or I'm not too sure, really. I was going to say like a pool or something, but I've already got water and stuff around the front. I'm not just going to do like a big swimming pool. I'll probably just do like little bits of water here and there. So I'm not too sure what I really want to do with this house. I thought it was going to be bigger, to be honest. When I started it, I thought it would turn out a lot bigger than it has actually turned out. But that's okay. That's kind of how it goes. Let's jump up here. I've added a little bit more to the roof since I last showed you. And I definitely think I'm going to have to get rid of this balcony walkway area and do a large room that goes out to about there, maybe. Not too sure, really. If you guys have got any ideas as to what different rooms I could put onto this, or any suggestions or anything, I'm open to suggestions, so just leave them in the comment section down below. This I may actually put like a secret room, basically just put like signs here and then a painting so that you can kind of see the painting through the window. Not too sure how that would work. We've got a little corridor here. May have to put some stairs or something in somewhere. We'll work that out once it's actually a proper building. In here, we've got a nice little attic room. This will probably be a bedroom, probably my bedroom. I'll put the bed here or something and just have some chests or something up here. Pretty cool. It's looking good. I definitely like the roof above it. Looking cool. Yeah, this, I think this has to go because it's too small. It doesn't really work with the roof and yeah, it's got to go, and I'm going to do some sort of building, and that will also disguise the fact that the roof is one block more on this side than it is on that side. So hopefully should make it look a lot better. And I just want to add some like weird rooms, like some large strange rooms. I may also do some stuff with minecarts. Somebody suggested doing a roller coaster or something. I definitely want to play around with minecarts. I'm not too sure what I'll do with them just yet. And also, somebody suggested that I make a world download for episode 30. I've never actually done a world download before, so I'm not too sure how we do it. But I'll try and work out how we do it, and it seems like a good idea. Although saying that, as I said in the start of the episode, I've had loads and loads of crashes actually trying to load into my own world. So if I give it to you guys to download and play on, be aware that you might have a lot of crashes when trying to load into it, and you may actually have to allocate more RAM to your Minecraft for you to actually be able to even load into it. Also, as well as chiseled blocks causing lag, planks do it as well. So I've switched out this planky staircase for more of a slab one. Hopefully that's less laggy and stuff. I've also bred some of the pigs. Cool. Yeah, world download. I think I'll try and do it, although be aware, you may actually get some crashes and stuff from loads of blocks and chiseled blocks and stuff like that, and not having enough RAM allocated. If you're basically stuck with a world that you can't load into because there's too many chiseled blocks and stuff, and you can't actually load into it to get rid of the chiseled blocks, I think you can use a program like MC Edit or World Edit. I don't think World Edit would work, but basically a third-party program where you can just go into your world without actually being in Minecraft and delete stuff like chiseled blocks or excessive amounts of animals or something like that. I've also noticed that the leaves, the amount of trees I've got around here and all the leaves and stuff has been causing some lag as well. So yeah, I think I'll try and do a world download for episode 30. Obviously, there's still another episode in between then and now. But yeah, I'll also try and get the house almost, or I'll get try and get some more of the house built for episode 30 so that there's actually some stuff to look around. But yeah, I think that's going to pretty much do it for today's episode, guys. We did some blast furnace stuff. I showed you how to make steel. Showed you how to breed the wolves and took a quick look around the house and all the stuff that I've got in it. So, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to hit that like button. As always, guys, it really helps me out. If you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Thanks for watching, as always, guys, and I will see you next time.